Money has various aliases: cash, dough, cream, mula, chapa, ufuk, mkwanja, maweng, guap, paper, majani, chapa, maziwa. I know you get it, right? As much as we love the sound from the ATM, whenever we're withdrawing money, there's always a story accompanying it. Either way, money has a lot of uses, and it is easy to spend, but extremely hard to generate. So before I begin, there's a disclaimer. Hello guys, welcome to Himscope KE. I'm King Omulo, and today we will be talking about the economics of living in Qatar. But first, let's begin by how we find ourselves here in the first place. Despite there being several gruesome articles published on social media about the life in Gulf countries, we still seem to have a certain hunger for money. Truth is, we literally came here to get the money. To some level, this might be the case compared to the situations we live in our home countries. The constant rising of unemployment, the instability combined with the lack of opportunities makes you consider leaving your home temporarily to migrate to the GCC countries for better untaxed salaries and wages. At least this way, we are able to make ends meet. So here, we are not going to discuss about the unethical recruitment practices, labor exploitation, or labor abuses, but rather the process after landing a well-paying job. We are going to stay positive. Positivity, viewers, positivity. For the most part, money has always been the motivation, be it to further our education, to grow our business, even to pursue our dreams. A lot of us youths today have great business ideas, but we lack enough monetary capital to begin our businesses. So what do? We get jobs, save up capital, or invest our salaries in projects that generate profit in a significant period. These jobs are not the professional kind of jobs. They are the semi-skilled, short contract, minimum wage jobs. So, what is minimum wage? Let's begin by defining minimum wage according to Google. This is the lowest amount of money a worker can be paid per hour, as per the labor law. Here in Qatar, the Ministry of Administrative Development, Labor and Social Affairs recently amended the minimum wage for workers to an accommodative amount. This is great, especially for us guys down here. We really appreciate it. Assuming everything goes perfectly and you land a good job, of course your motivation, the money, is good enough to help you build whatever you want. Of course, you have people who depend on you, so you are able to lift them from poverty to average. And now, they applaud you as the village champion. Soon, you will want more. Maybe start a small business to bring in passive income as you plan on doing it big later on. See, the thing about money is it can never be enough. So if money is your motivation, then you're truly doomed. See, here in Qatar, the amount of money you make per month is dependent on the amount of time you spend on the job. You spend less hours, you get less money. You spend more time, you're paid overtime. You are absent from work, you're not paid for the day. So if you're chasing money, then you will miss a lot and you'll never be satisfied. See, we often hear people say the phrase, work smart, not hard. You see, this doesn't mean that hard work doesn't pay. It simply means that you turn your misfortunes into fortunes For example, that minimum wage job that you are doing right now. Yeah, that one. See, it is minimum wage because the market perceives it like that. That is the market's perceived value of that job. So when you in what you do is you increase your perceived value in a way that you are not easily dispensable. That way you can be able to be in a position to earn more. Add short courses, enhance what you do. All that has been about production and how to generate more money. But how important is that if your problem isn't about production but consumption? You can be paid 30, maybe 50, or even 100,000 riyal per month, and you blew it in less than a month. People often say money is the root of all evil. But is that true? Is that true? See, my understanding is money amplifies your attitude whenever you're around it. Hence why, when you have money, you are praised and your ego is caressed with names like Bazoo, Mkuu, President, King, etc. I know you know them. See, the thing is, the choices we make when we have money has everything to do with our morals. We also need to understand that our formal education doesn't teach us about managing money. We need to teach ourselves that there is no need to acquire what we can't manage, increasing your perceived value only to be living on a financial edge. You are only one salary away from being broke. For us, the youth, our perception of consumption is crucial to our ability to generate. Therefore, when you happen to have a little bit of savings in your account, your horizons are broadened. You even want things that you don't actually need. But when it comes to work stuff, you're tired, can't wait for the day to end. You just lazy around, sleep around. You probably don't get along with your superiors because of reasons you cannot even say. To make matters worse, you have responsibilities. The moment you receive your salary, poof, it sublimes into thin air. Your job ends up being a necessity, such that without it, you're totally doomed. See, someone might ask, why am I telling you this? Why am I on your case with all this? Truth is, I'm trying to raise awareness so that you get to see the value in yourselves. Your dream being on the top percent of the food chain might actually come true. In the end, we are not competing. We are uplifting each other because we all have different goals. Get to build your net worth. The goal should not be chasing money. Rather, it should be being financially independent. I'm not saying that you can't live a little, have fun, enjoy yourselves, buy some nice clothes and everything. No, but at least do it responsibly. So, how do we help those who have an expenditure problem? How do we better ourselves? How do we make ourselves not fall in this trap of living on a financial edge? The first thing you do is you need to journal your expenses into categories. Write down budgets. Avoid hyperbolic discounting because this leads to the ostrich effect. Hyperbolic discounting is when you favor short-term rewards for long-term rewards. In Swahili, we say kupigia mwili pole. This ends up being going overboard. And the ostrich effect is when you don't want to look at your receipt because you want to avoid the negative financial news. You don't want to see your overspending and everything. So in summary, Since we all know that we have vested interest in getting money, get that money, but don't overspend on unnecessary stuff. Understand whatever it is that you are purchasing and why you are purchasing it. Coming to this realization this late still helped me to get closer to my dreams. I'm sure it will help you too. If you have reached this part of the video, then it means that I've really made sense. I opened up my heart about money being your motivation, it shouldn't be your motivation, and I appreciate you watching. If you'd like to see me making more videos like this, click on the subscribe button and click the notification bell. To interact with me on a one-on-one, follow me on Instagram and Twitter at King Omulo. Follow Himscope KE on both Instagram and Twitter to get to know about us. Till next time, I've been your host, King Omulo. Wolan.